So I just received an email, opened it, very, very lengthy and very frightening. Now, just to let you know, I do get a lot of emails and I read every single one. This one just came in my mailbox. Oh, by the way, if you wanted to know who the migrants are voting for, which probably comes to no shock to you, cue the fire. But in this email, it lays out mathematically what I've been saying. Whereas in a debt-based system, and you have Janet, Treasury, creating bonds, you pay it back in your taxes, it works at first. But then towards the end, it doesn't work. It's like two magnets and like, wow, that was fast. Also in this email, he said I was right. How the Fed does not print money, and you are correct in the comments section. It was a rough week. So yes, after reading this email and crunching numbers, it's a bad week to stop sniffing glue. Also, I had mentioned, because I get in and I get out of GLD, SLV, I don't really sell too much of my physical. Also, there will come a point where when this breaks, it will break, because mathematically it has to, that these things you won't, this is gold. Okay, that's gold. That's silver. The ratio actually to silver, look at this, almost 400 to 1. This is actually a better investment. I mean, look at the crypto ratio. This is the money. Also, when it breaks, like I said, you won't be able to get this. You won't be able to get this. And if you don't have this, you're cuckoo. Because this is listen, it's real. And right now in this scenario that we're currently in, I'd probably say we are maybe right there. I mean, you tell me, this is 1966. You know, you can go back to 1900, flat line. And that's what happens. It's just like flat, nothing. We're fine. You know, we go off the gold standard there. No standard. And then all of a sudden it's like, ooh, that's bad. And then, ooh, jump, that was bad. And then, ooh, jump, that was bad. And then look at that pop. And then that pop. And mind you, this all has to be paid back in your taxes. The question is, how much is too much? Where it basically, it's the camel's back and it breaks. I mean, this was just bumped a few years. We were at 266, then 333. Debt to GDP, 150. And some of you might say, who cares about 150% debt to GDP? And who cares about my taxes that I owe? Well, I think you should, because it's not going away. And it's Dr. Lacey Hunt. I think he probably manages a $5 billion hedge fund. I don't know. Says U.S. headed for a hard landing. Okay. But he also says anything, I think it was above 80% debt to GDP, no matter how much debt you issue, you have no growth. So the United States can't grow, even though they say, oh, you know, GDP grew at 3%, 2%, or whatever, where they give people stimulus, right? That was an effect. Issue $10 trillion, okay? Half of it goes over here, half of it goes over there. How much GDP growth? Not much. Then we start going backwards. And then the government's like, we can't have that. So more debt means more taxes, or like what you'll see in New York. Let's give people, let's unlimited. Now, he didn't say unlimited, but it gets there. Migrants, you guys all get debit cards. And if you go to jail, you get out and you get, I don't know, thousands of dollars. This is what's happening. What you need to understand is these people are running the show. Do you think they even know what I'm talking about? They don't. Do you think they care? They don't. They care about being reelected. I mean, do you think that, take this guy, this very handsome Gavin Newsom, cares about you? No, he cares about the vote. Does he care that raising minimum wage to $20 will put everyone out of business? He doesn't care. Because people will be like, yeah, boy, I'm making 20. Oh, wait, I just got laid off. I mean, just in one day, Burger King in Texas, you were paying 15 bucks for that. Now you're paying almost 17. And all these new happy faces coming over the border, you think he cares? No, you get reelected. I actually used to teach this in high school. I used to teach debt. I used to actually teach how to double your money, how to invest, how to trade, how to be a millionaire by the time you're 30. And it is all just math, just like what is happening now. It's math. You can't change it. You can't fix it. They're going to try. It's not going to work. The game's over. But with this exponential growth that's just starting, okay, crazy. You're like, wait, we're at 30, 40 trillion. Oh, it's just like 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. Because at the beginning, it doesn't seem so bad. This is what I used to teach. If you were, I'd say, hey, I'll give you $100,000 to my students. Come work for me for 31 days. I'll cut you a check. You can have it right now. Or I will pay you every day one penny for 31 days. The catch is I double it. So day one, one penny, day two pennies, three, four pennies, day four, and they start doing the math. And then at about day 17, they're at $655. They're like, I'll take the 10 grand. I'm like, are you sure you don't want to put in like 14 more days work to see if it, no, it's fine. I'm like, okay, how about 20 grand? Okay, we'll do 20, 30, 30, that's it. The entire class will take the 30 grand. Rather than the ending. The ending is 11 million dollars. If you go 32 days, it's $22 million. Then if you could just squeeze out one more day, right? You're in the 40 millions. But ladies and gentlemen, boys and squirrels, you are witnessing the end. And within 12 months, we'll be at just interest on the debt is in the trillions. The problem is we don't bring that in. So a solution is you might want to learn about real money. Learn how to make money going up, learn how to make money going down, learn how to make money going sideways. Hurry up and get to a point where it's being compounded and I will blow the roofs off your doors. But I know it's that darn waiting game. It's always the beginning. I don't have enough. Once you get to a certain point, it's like you just become uber rich. And then on this channel, I give you the stock setups. Off of this channel, I give you the watch list. This is my bear market go down, bull market go up, and options sideways. You could do almost any strategy. Just start with my swing trade on this EL. And see, I have not moved past it. Look at this. Beat down, purple nurple, nine count comes on. What's going to happen after that? It runs. And there is not one time underneath the Bravo 9. I turned it red for you. Usually when I'm live trading, I like blue. But I know on this channel, you're like, I can't see it. Also, grab my sale 80% off, whatever course you want. Please start there and then exit right there. Since you already missed it, this is the next setup. This rejected on the 200. Rejected. What do you think? Also, let me grab my crayon and draw something for you. This is a great setup, but you can't exponentially make your digits go up if you haven't done my bear market. You don't know how to make money going down and you're still stuck working at your job, paying more, $17 now, then 20. And then 50, and then 100. Did you solve it? I gave you solutions. Then every day I come onto this channel and punch myself in the face because I have to listen to trolls in the comments. Oh, I could get all this for free online. Okay, Scott, go ahead. And I'm pretty sure Scott is also names that I use on the channel are usually friends of mine or strippers. Skylar was actually my daughter, JoJo flight attendant on YouTube. Her best friend was named Skylar. Why I turned him into a guy, I don't know. It's just the culture. Funny thing is, I was just thinking about my kids' friends. A lot of them are multimillionaires now, and almost all of them went through my classes. Skylar actually travels the world. She just travels the world. Begs. She was in my class. She sells Etsy notes on Etsy. She became a nurse, sells her notes, and is a multimillionaire on Etsy. Oh, I wonder where she learned this stuff from. Jake, he started Movement Watches, I think sold for $300 million. I have a course on it. And it could be dumb things like this gold bar. This guy who I bought it from makes almost $2,000 a month. Link in the description for the price of a textbook, $99. I almost died doing that course. And yes, I launched products and here's one. Anywho, the regular Joe. Credit card debt surges. Do you see? It's like we the people and the government. You're all in lockstep. Surges to all-time high. Just as card APR rates hit fresh record. Oh my gosh, what are you going to do? You're probably going to file for bankruptcy. I don't know. I don't know what's going to happen. Everything points to a recession. Everything points to lowering, like the economy slowing. And if not now, you can't. Fix this. I know some of you are like, well, this is what Jerome will do. Okay, Bravo, what you don't understand is that debt clock you keep using, well, the Fed can bring rates down to zero. So that interest on debt really won't be $3 trillion every year. It'll be lower. But the truth is, and I've told you on this channel, the Fed doesn't do anything money. I know, crazy, right? It doesn't even do anything interest rate. Well, except for the Fed funds rate. I get it, between banks. That has a slight effect on the front end. It has no effect on the 30-year, the 20-year, the 10-year. I mean, the closer you get to the front end, okay, a little bit. There's also the banks will play arbitrage, but anyways, they just sit there. It's just a balance sheet. They have a balance sheet. That's it. And they do loans. And they go on TV. But the Fed doesn't do BRRRR. Janet creates bonds. That's where some money, which, again, money could be anything. It could be, I don't know, you get on a plane and you get airline miles, right? You could use that as money. It's just so many things can be considered money. But the bonds that Janet creates has to be paid back with interest. Just in a couple years, you're looking at $3 trillion just in interest. And the Fed can't fix it. And your 10-year yield, which is at 4.38, I'm guessing. I need to get a life. I said 4.38, it's 4.40. They're not fixing it. All they do is chase this one right here, 4.7. It's a 2-year yield. If I pull up the Fed, which I have a bazillion times, the Fed funds rate, it goes in line with that. And usually when that comes down, they're like, okay, we'll pivot. And when that goes up, they say, we'll wait until we don't look stupid and then we'll follow it. But what's frightening is these are not coming down. Macro says they have to come down. They haven't been coming down. Where I made a macro play and lost my pantalones. So there is the possibility that rates stay high. That's because the whole world, you either buy bonds or you don't buy bonds. If you buy bonds, rates go one way. If you don't buy bonds, they go the other way. Kind of a supply and demand. You want them? Okay. You don't want them? Okay, rates go down. Until we can get to that sweet place where you actually will buy them or the world will buy them. And just to circle back around, this guy cannot fix it. This guy cannot fix it. An orange guy can't fix it. An alien can't. No one can fix this. I mean, just look at like the Fed. Look at here. How's the Fed doing? They're doing okay. Oh, except for that exponential red line. And that's basically their balance sheet. I mean, look, they're doing good. No, they're out. Everything's out. Ponzi scheme's over. Let the market rip higher. Whatever. Everything is just expenses. There's no earnings. I mean, look, Fed's expenses exceeds earnings. In 2023, interest rates climb. We can't seem to get a handle on that. And the Fed's sitting there like, I don't know, what do we do? Imagine if they cut rates, which they could. They cut Fed funds rate. Ooh. And rates keep rocketing higher. Oh boy, don't you look like an idiot. And what they don't want is to lose control or the perceived value or the perceived image that they've lost control. Like raising kids, you know, when they're 14, they're like, well, I'll just call CPS. Or you find out like, man, I can't do anything. It was like teaching in high school. I'm like, is there any consequence? Nope, no consequence. I actually taught at a school for like 1 or 2 years. It was a high school. It was in Santa Clarita. It was great. Great experience. The kids, I like at-risk kids. And that's just me. We have fun. I am an at-risk kid, as you can see. But the kids figured out. They could just come in. They would punch the cops in the face. Everyone would just punch them, not do any work, not do anything, smoke weed. The cops would show up. They're like, our hands are tied. The principal would say, my hands are tied. There's no consequences because they figured it out. When people figure out, one, you don't have any money in your bank account. Two, it's not money. Three, it's not in there. Four, it's been loaned away. Five, money doesn't even exist. It's a Ponzi scheme. It's just debt. Six, there's no one in charge of this thing. Seven, let's just let them all come on over the border and at least I'll get reelected. Oh, and something a little bit more frightening, but it would take me a whole nother video, is bull steepener, bear steepener, or steepening. And something broke. And everything in the back end is breaking. Here we go again. Exponentially faster. I wish I had a solution for you. I don't. But what I do have is maybe a little wisdom. Maybe you want to subscribe to kind of get some interesting wisdom that maybe you didn't learn in school, nor college, nor family, nor anyone, nor the media. But I don't want you to get mad at, oh, it's this guy, once this guy's in, or this politician, or once I vote this way or that way. You can't fix a debt-based system. You can't fix exponential growth that's happening right about now. You witnessed that 3 years ago. It was right after the government says just 2 weeks to slow the, I'm not even going to finish that line because I know there's bots, right? Oh, we got you. The government is here. We will save you. We watched in 12 months, right? Just everything go bonkers. It has only gotten worse every day. But again, don't get mad at these people. Look at this. Departing Boeing CEO, be a CEO. Be a president, start a company. That's what I teach you. Exits at $33 million in compensation. Good job, bro. See, a logical person is like, wait a minute, all your planes are crashing. And that's kind of biblical. When things start falling out of the sky, bring on the locusts, walk away with $33 million. Trade it. Make your digits go to $33 million. It cannot happen if you don't do anything. And that's why I keep bugging you. I am sorry. I will not come on this channel every day and go, let me tell you how bad things are and just leave it at that. Or let me tell you how bad things are. Link in the description for my gold or silver. I'm not going to do that either. Because this money, having money, I mean, money solves problems. I got you. But you got to have it coming in. Just buying gold and silver, that you, congratulations, you now have money. Now, how do you double that, triple that, quadruple that based on this system that is happening? Do you have the knowledge? If you do, congratulations. Don't get your butt out of the chair and do something. Hey, there you go. And I love you and work every day, just like me, of your life, because you like it. And I'll see you tomorrow.